Hello boys and girls, welcome to peek over my shoulder again in my diddle daddling about Zaton Piggy. This is a new day, a new session. I need to gather my bearings a little bit. I mean, the chase the poltergeist is still fresh in my mind. Now I sort of need to remember what is it that I'm actually trying to do here. Right, I think I should pick up some more random stashes, and I believe there is one stuffed tree crotch in this area, because I could use some radiation protection, or well, not protection but counter agent. Anything in this bush? Nope, just the bush. Oh wait, I think I can pick up Joker's PDA right now, because I think there aren't any dogs or anything over there right now. Unless there are. Anything under this? Nope. And my overarching current task is to get myself a more decent detector than the Echo. I'm not even going to try getting any artifacts with the Echo. Instead, I'm gonna give them time to mature and whatnot. Bushes look the same to me. Back in the day, I could have sworn that I had checked inside all the pine bushes and under all the spruce trees, but I'm pretty sure that isn't the case, because it's so easy to miss some. So the Echo won't even detect the little colobok on top there. Ooh, rain! Nice. Soft. Irradiated, probably. Although if I follow the knowledge, or if going by the stories or the narration of one of my neighbors in countryside, not last year countryside, but 1 year before that, I stayed over half a year. I stayed with my demented aunt in a grand operation of granny sitting, and it turned out that not just one of our neighbors in that countryside, but two of the neighbors had been liquidators. One of them had been to Chernobyl as a rookie military recruit, and another had been there as part of road building crew, and the one who did the road building, he had okay. I'm gonna stand on the rock so that I can speak my story without interruption. So the guy who was in Chernobyl building roads, he had one nugget of wisdom was that one major source of radiation, or one thing that they had to look out for, was when moving gravel, because the dust and gravel were infused with the cesium isotope. So you had to, when you were paving the roads, you had to be pouring the gravel very slowly, not to kick up any of that dust. And another story, which I might have told elsewhere, is they had a daily safe dose that they could be, or like the daily quota of radiation that they were allowed to be exposed to, and they soon found out that certain roofs, is it thatch? Yeah, I think it's called thatch roofs, and piles of manure were giving off extra radiation for some reason, and the way it was explained was that certain microbes, they basically gobble up the organic material, and as part of their metabolism they then excrete extra material, so they sort of amplify the irradiated stuff, because science. So the work crew pretty much worked out a way. How to easily amp up their daily quota without having to actually go into the hot zone too much. They picked up a piece of manure from one of those quote-unquote amplified piles, put it in the woods near their lodging, and then every day took their instruments near there, which meant they kicked up their quota and could enjoy a little bit of not so hard work. Okay, yoink. Okay. And yoink. Oh, it has extra psi protection and extra chemical protection. And this one, okay, this one also. So this one has a little bit higher of the same protection. Gotcha. So back to the stashes also, before I forget. Oh, I don't have any vodka on me. I'll be back. I usually drop a bottle of vodka between his ribs, just as a little nice gesture. Okay, so let's find that tree crotch. Anybody behind me? I hope that the video doesn't turn out too dark. I mean, for the night footage, I actually amp up the brightness before rendering. But for the day shots, right now I increased brightness one notch, and I hope it's enough, because I don't want to add brightness to the day shots, because it's gonna look unnatural, in my opinion. Push, 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 push. Is that the tree? Nope. Not the tree. Oh, one optional feature that I turned on, I believe, was random anomalies, so I should actually kind of watch out and not dawdle around too willy-nilly, I guess. Okay, while the piggies don't pay any mind to me, I'm not gonna attack them. Right. Let's do this old school. See? It can be done. this is a truly masochistic method of getting shit out of trees. Although I believe I was even able to get the ammo from that other tree with the bolt method. Oh, you're just gonna dangle there, aren't you? Okay, let's pick this up. Come on, just grab it! This is a matter of principle now. Okay, aim a little off. Uh-oh. Yeah, old school my ass. Okay, let's grab the last one. Do I have any mutant parts on me? No, luckily. Yo, Biggie! Shall we play? If I get one of them away from the group. Yeah. They are kind of slow and complacent here. The fleshies in Shadow of Chernobyl aren't as susceptible to stabbing. I mean, they move faster if I'm... Well, might be just my perception, but they seem to be running faster. They dodge more and they... Their bite is a tad more bitter. Let me make a manual save here before I get into anything too stupid. Nothing here. How about this bush? Nope. Yeah, I'm gonna leave the rest of the piggies alone. For now. Resume my walkabout in the greens. Or should I say, in the pines? I should also watch out because I think I'm getting into bloodsucker territory now. Dead, full of reckless abandon. Thinking I should probably go to the forestry or forest processing plant or whatever. I don't know what's the proper English translation for it. and get the big shotgun from there. I mean, if I keep on moving with my relaxed pace, I will end up there at some point anyway. Hello. I wonder, can I circle this area so that I don't agitate the wild pig in? And so that I won't have to run. Because until Dexterov gains some stones, he ain't that great on running. Slipper slope already. Okay. Fair enough. Hello. Yoink. I think I have several. Ah, no, that wasn't Hercules at all. So what do we have here? Anti-chemical. Usually the same type of stashes aren't placed so close together, but you can never know. It's better to have checked and come empty than not to have checked at all. Come up empty. I don't know. Not speak English. You just wait there. Don't fly anywhere or anything. Here the anomaly. Well, anomalies. getting very bushy here and I'm starting to lose my orientation, so let us drift back towards the campsite. I want to know who's there. Heyo, what happened there? Everything just stopped and froze for a second. Undoubtedly some reality-bending anomaly. When you play the first time, there is this extra joy, or the Snoop Vision joy of discovering shit the first time. But when you play after a long, long pause, then there's like double joy. Point one, there's the joy of discovery, because you've forgotten all shit, so everything is like as if for the first time again. But at the same time, you also get the joy of, oh, I actually remembered that! Right, I'm not gonna go into the ruins because I think some of the anomalies extend there. Oops. Yeah, let's put that away. Oh, hello! You've had a busy day.
Неплохо, неплохо. За одну ходку две ночные звезды.
What does it do?
Если так и дальше пойдет, в гробу я видал ваш хваленый клондайк.
Show me again what you have.
Ах, неохота мне за хабаром сегодня плестись. Сейчас бы дома оказаться, в гамачке, да с книжкой толковой.
Банкер, а? So what are you up to anyway?
А все-таки накоплю я на свой домик,
okay.
Чтобы речки
Quiet
и
time.
Лес рядом.
Got it.
И не радиации тебе, ни тварей, ни сволочей разных.
Okay, he's telling about the ghost ship thingy.
Эх, вот всегда бы такая пруха была. Это если прикинуть... Ага, точно. 3-4 таких похода, как вчера. Да если бы еще хабар не хуже. И все. Завязываю с зоной нахрен.
So, are you gonna just sit there all day? If so, I'm gonna go explore this way. Although, it would be useful to hang out with him in case he doesn't survive because he has an artifact on him. Oh, hello, dogs.
Ёлы-палы, ну надо же. Вчера Припять видел. Вот так же, своими глазами. Сказал бы, кто месяц назад...
Yo! Get fighting! Shit! Thank you. Uh-oh. I think the dogs got him. That isn't exactly the kind of... outcome I would have wanted. Okay, let's see now. Yeah, he's toast. Whoa. Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna need that stuff now. So let's see. What did we get? Just gonna drop these here. Somebody will find them. Oh, I have so many grenades. It's almost obscene. Wait. Okay, so knife is using this ammo. Good to know. Uh-oh. This quiet. It sounds like one of those pre-blowout quiets. Okay, now that I have extra food, let us eat something. Rat ourselves. Right. Oh, hey. The campfire is still on. Does this mean somebody else is coming this way or what? Woo! Vodka for life! I mean, vodka forever! I'm not gonna take your shooter. Well, wasn't this an unfortunate happening? So what was the data that they got off him? I think some of these might be duplicating. I haven't kept tabs on the volume numbers, so it could be that each different stalker holds a different piece of the story. But so far, I suspect that I have gotten at least two pieces of volume 4. Let's check these bushes. Nope. And the flies are already on it. Now, once I obtain some sort of anti-radiation artifact, I will be able to eat mutant parts as well, I think. I mean, if it's strong enough. The artifact, I mean. look like airplane tracks, kinda. Again, it's this sort of kinda quiet, kind of overcast, hinting at possible blowout coming. Like a pre-blowout quiet. Pre-blowout disquiet quiet. Nope. Oh, more dogs. So yeah, one dog is a nuisance, pack of dogs is a hazard. Can't remember if there was a stash in this folder. Semi-chaotically. Damn it. Also, my aim is kinda shit. Oh, okay. Got one. You know what? Since I'm so far from my previous location, manual save here. Since I'm so close to the Twilight Zone, since I'm about to explore this segment now, I think it is appropriate to call the episode. I have achieved so much. I have picked up like 2 stashes and looted 1 whole corpse. So yes, it is indeed an appropriate time to call the episode. Thank you very much for watching. See you soon and bye bye for now.